Thank you for your patience.
Wait, we're missing one. I'm sorry. Oh, okay, he's here. Okay. Thank you. All present and accounted for.
All right.
Who was here?
Again, thank you. Assemblywoman Nolan.
Okay. And thank you, Senator Flanagan. You know, it gets hectic at the end like this, and we try to make sure we have everybody here, and people are running to different meetings. Our joint budget subcommittee has been given a table target by leadership. Obviously, we went through this last year. There was certainly, we never think it's enough in the education community. We're always concerned. But you know, I want to qualify that. We want to make sure that there's enough. I mean, there is a number where we might all say that's plenty, but we haven't quite gotten there, particularly for children in high needs districts. And we have to remember what a wealthy state we indeed are and what a wonderful state we are and how important the education of our children is. Right now, we are talking about a table target of $231 million for the state fiscal year, and that would be over the governor's proposal, obviously, which was at about $1 billion. I want to remind colleagues, we spend about $22 billion to educate the 3 million children in K-12, and of course, also some money, a lot of additional money goes for higher education. This target of $231 million, and it's hard to believe when you do this, as long as Senator Flanagan and I do it, seems somewhat small, and I can tell you that I'm sure every member of this committee will be pushing and pushing and pushing over the next few days to work with the executive and both houses to make sure that the money is adequate to fund the expenses of the running the schools of our state and also allow us to do some of the things we must do to have educational equity. So the $231 million is not limited to increases in school aid, for example, under the rubric of foundation aid or GEA, full reimbursement of expense-based aids, obviously foundation and GEA, and then, you know, there's some additional funding that usually comes out, some categorical grants, and of course, our libraries, which we come under this committee as well. I do want to remind people that we have 674 school districts, so the costs are great. We have a number of specialized programs in schools that we also fund, and so I think, I don't want to speak for everyone on the committee, but I think we clearly would like to push beyond $231 million additional dollars, but that's our target right now, and we have to understand and be prudent and understand that we have to work for the moment with what we've been given. Having said that, I know everybody on this committee is very strong, as I know Senator Flanagan and I have both been over the years, and what a pleasure it is to work together. We're going to keep pushing, and we're going to see where we're at.
Thank you very much. Sometimes brevity is the order of the day, and I don't want to be repetitive in terms of what the Assemblywoman said and the General Conference Committee, but obviously we're grateful. And I'll take a slightly different tact, although I concur with what was just offered by my colleague on behalf of the Assembly. If you look at the number that gives us our table target, we're at a potential growth in aid to education on the order of about 6%. And if you look at the personal income growth index that we had in statute, we would be at 1.7%. So we're already triple what existing statute is. And I'd also just respectfully add, while people are going to clamor for more money, we certainly are mindful of the fact, because we all deal with a variety of different issues, that there will be mental health advocates, people for OPWDD, transportation, environment, health, who are all going to come in and say, we wish we were getting that largesse. So that's a challenge for us, not necessarily for the public at large, but we ultimately have to come to some kind of compromise, not only in education. And I'm sure we're going to have very detailed discussions. Those are taking place already and will throughout the course of the next couple of days. And we are certainly going to be mindful of our areas like 853, Special Acts, and those types of entities, and the 4201s who are always looking for our help. So I'm confident that we are in accord on that, and I just appreciate everyone's patience and courtesy.
One just follow-up, though, quickly. I want to make it clear that because of the Campaign for Fiscal Equity lawsuit, and what we did in 2007, and then we fell behind in 2008 because we had a fiscal crisis. I, too, always want to be fiscally prudent. You know, in Ridgewood, where I live, people balance their budget every day, and in Western Queens, we do that every day, and we'll continue to do that, and we as a legislature must balance our budget. But I think we have to remember, unlike some of these other issue areas, there is a court order, there was a settlement of that court order, there is a desire to finally address the inequities in our state, because so much is based on property wealth. We have to do something to get these high needs districts the money they need so that every child can have not just an adequate education, but as the court settlement, as Judge Kaye wrote in the settlement, a meaningful education that, as the original 1894 Constitution said, is for the rising generations to come. And that's the purpose of our committee, and I always salute my colleagues in the Senate majority and our two sets of colleagues in the minority conferences, because that's what we're here to do, and that's what we intend to do, and that's what we intend to push for as best we can. If anybody else would like to say a word, I know if Assemblyman Ra would like to, and then if any, with Senator Latimer, I don't know, John, that's Edward.
Thank you, Chairwoman. Just quickly, you know, as we move through this process, we're going to have that back and forth, like you just mentioned, in terms of where that money's going. Just again to reiterate on behalf of the minority, the importance of the gap elimination adjustment. And quickly, Senator Flanagan mentioned our special acts and our 853s and our 4201s, which continue to be a priority. And I neglected the other day to just also mention the 4410 special education preschool programs, who are also struggling. So I've had the opportunity to visit some of those programs that are doing excellent work. And we hope we, you know, continue to discuss, whether it's within this budget or afterwards, addressing some of those issues as well. Thank you.
Thank you. John, anybody on your side? Senator Latimer, anybody from the press? Okay. Anybody else? A word? Okay. I think we're going to say to be continued. And I look forward to seeing everybody and talking with everyone over the weekend. Keep your cell phones on. And we'll be in touch with everyone, and thank you very much. I want to thank Speaker Hastie and Senator Skelos for entrusting us with this great responsibility. Thank you.